हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक इन द प्लेटफॉर्म ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स इंजीनियरिंग. सो फोर्थ यूनिट ऑपरेशनल एम्पलीफायर वी वॉज डिस्कसिंग. सो जस्ट एज अ ब्रीफ रिवीजन व्हाट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड ऑलरेडी, दैट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव डिस्कस ऑपरेशनल एम्पलीफायर सिंबल. दिस इज अ प्लस, दिस इज अ माइनस. वन टर्मिनल वोल्टेज इज हेयर, सपोज V2 इज हेयर, सपोज V1 इज हेयर. And what is the Vout? Vout is depend on whatever the gain is here. This is called AOL, open loop gain. So V output is equal to AOL, that is the gain, multiplied by voltage difference of the voltage input. And this is a V2 is attached with the positive terminal. So it is called, it is as V2 minus V1. This is V1 multiplied by AOL. This will be our output. So we have already discussed this, and DC biasing is also there, that is VCC minus VEE. Again, I am repeating, the DC biasing important because this is a triangle, it is a symbol basically. And amplification happens because of few transistors or MOSFETs are inside this triangle. So we know that very well, that for a transistor, DC biasing important because DC biasing keeps the transistor in a particular zone. Like BJT is important to be in active region, active zone, if I want to use BJT as an amplifier. And the same thing, this concept I have already mentioned many times in the class. Okay, so this was the previous lecture revision, you can say. And when after that I discussed the internal structure of the operational amplifier, that what is the inside the operational amplifier triangle symbol. So I can say here that this is a RS, this is source, and this is a V1 voltage, and this is I have connected with RI, that is internal resistance of the operational amplifier. And operational amplifier basically amplifying it. And what is the its difference of voltage here, that is called VD, and it will amplify the VD, and this is become AOL multiplied by VD. So this is, and this is the output resistance of the amplifier, and further we receive the output here. So if we hold this area, if I will cover like this the way I will cover, I already discussed in the class before. So this is a triangle actually. So this complete area of this complete the things inside the triangle, that I can show it is an operational amplifier. So this is a symbol only, symbol, and this is, I can say, the internal structure, internal parameters, I can say. So that I discussed, and here I attach a load RL, and with the load I can get my V out plus minus. Because with the load I can get V output. So we have seen that already, that we will get V output is equal to here V2 minus V1 multiplied by AOL. When we will get it? Whenever RI is equal to infinite and R out is equal to 0. So we have discussed this already. So if today again just I am comparing both ideal op amp and practical op amp. So if I will just compare, because that is mentioned in your syllabus too, and they may ask the 2 marks question and the 5 marks question, what is the difference. So ideally, what should be the value of input resistance? It must be RI is equal to infinite. What should be the output resistance? This must be 0 ohm. What is the gain AOL should be? It's like infinite. What is the bandwidth? I have already discussed bandwidth. It must be infinite. So these all are parameters. This is one parameter, 2, 3, and 4 parameters. So these are parameters, and all the values I have written here just for the ideal case. You have to remember that. So these for the ideal. Now we know that we assume some of the things in the electronics circuits ideal. But that is not possible. So practically we try to achieve these values. So if anybody will ask the question, what is the value of practical op amps of these parameters? So if I will write down here input resistance, it must be very high. It cannot be practically infinite, because infinite doesn't mean that infinite exists. So it must be very high. It means it must be in the mega ohms. What is the R naught? R naught must be very low. Low means it must be in the range of ohms. If it is in the ohms, it means it is a 5 ohm or a 2 ohm. So these values comes in the range of very low value. So what is the value of a gain, open loop gain? Ideally it should be infinite, but it should be very high, and it should be equal to approx 10 to the power 6 gain. I'm just, unit is gain is voltage divided by voltage, so there is no unit, but I can convert this into the decibel. I 20 log of gain 10, 20 log base 10 mod of AOL. Is it in decibel? Okay. So what is the bandwidth? Bandwidth should be very high. So just I have mentioned these is few things that I have already discussed in the previous class, because this is the very important and the basic of operational amplifier. You cannot forget these things, because if you will forget, the whole unit is, you need to, you know, cram that only. You can't understand. So this is a symbol. Symbol I mentioned here. Then you have to understand the internal structure. That is this. What is the property and parameter? I can say it is the ideal operational amplifier. It is this. And what is the practical amplifier? Like this. So here I have not attached any feedback. So this is completely open loop analysis I did. What I did? Open loop analysis. If you know well network and control, maybe the control is not in syllabus now, but if you are a student of network even, you are much aware about the open loop. So this is a whole analysis I discussed, the open loop analysis. So this is very important. What I did here today, I did analyze completely open loop analysis. So now this was discussed. Come to the another concept of the operational amplifier. That's also very, very important. Like, suppose here I have taken that ideal operational amplifier. And ideal operational amplifier, it is a triangle. It's very simple like, and this is a negative, positive. These are two terminal voltage attached, and this is V output, and this is open loop gain. So what is my open loop gain is? V output divided by, that is the difference between two, like this is a V2 and this is V1. So I can say it is V2 minus V1, or I can say it V output divided by Vd. I hope it is clear. What is my gain is? That is open loop gain. No feedback it is as there. So open loop gain is V output upon Vid. But ideally I want to make it infinite. Why I want to make it infinite? Because I want to operate the system ideally. Because ideal system give me the perfect and 100% accurate output. So I want to make my this open loop gain infinite. If I want to make it infinite, what I can do? Two things are possible. First is V output is infinite, or Vd equal to 0. Then you think about a bit, just pause my video and think about what is the possibility. This is first possibility is can occur, or second possibility can occur. I mean, which is the possible thing? I want to make this gain, open loop gain, infinite. So infinite is the two possibilities are there. Either I will take output infinite, or I will take Vd is equal to 0. So this is the second possibility is only possible. Why? Because V output is equal to infinite doesn't mean, because your system cannot give infinite output. No system can give even infinite output practically. So this condition is not possible. I mean, this condition is not possible. Only this condition is possible. So if I want to make this operation amplifier ideal, I will try to reduce Vd equal to 0. What is the mean of Vd equal to 0? V difference of the two voltage which I have applied in the both terminal 1 and 2, I mean V1 and V2 must be same. V1 must be equal to same. If I will come on this circuit, what is the VD here? VD potential between this terminal, suppose this is A terminal and this is a B terminal, and I want to make this system ideal. I mean, whenever I am considering this operational amplifier, this is a big triangle, it's like a hair. If I will dictate and I will take the gain of this triangle, I mean gain of this open loop is equal to infinite, then the potential of A terminal and potential of B terminal must be same. I mean VA is equal to VB. Today I am discussing this concept. This is the one of the most important concept of operational amplifier. This is called virtually short. And I hope that you will get the point here. What I did here, I have taken ideal operational amplifier. Because of ideal operational amplifier, gain of open loop must be infinite, and its gain must be infinite. So there is a one possibility occur that difference of the voltage that is going to apply in both the terminal must be zero, and if it will happen, V1 equal to V2 automatically it comes. So here, but here V1 is equal to not equal to V2. We know that V1 is different voltage than V2. Then how we can do this ideal operational amplifier can work as a ideally? So here I am just coming back on this circuit, that suppose here we have applied V1 and V2, but inside the terminal this is A and B, and I want to make VD is equal to zero, because this is open loop gain is infinite. So VD is equal to zero, and when VD is equal to zero, VA must be equal to VD, VA must be equal to VB. And what does it mean? If two voltages like this A and B are equal, it means they are short. What we have studied in the network analysis, you all are very good student of network, and you must be very good in the network subject too, because that is a basic pillar of all the subjects, as I personally believe. So when VA is equal to VB, you have from network analysis, you have to take this short A and B. But here, can you do that A and B short? What will happen if you will short A and B? If you will short A and B, it means you are shorting this resistor too. It means you are making RI is equal to 0 volt, 0 ohm. But here in the ideal condition, we have taken RI is equal to infinite. It means if you are doing A and B short, you are doing wrong, because you are converting RI 0. But here ideally RI must be infinite. So you can't physically connect A and B. You can't make it 0. You can't connect this A and B physically. So what you can do? You can do one thing without physically connection. You can do virtually short. To achieve VD is equal to 0, what you can do? You can short V1 and V2 virtually. This is very important. For ideal operational amplifier, if you want to make it ideal operational amplifier, you need gain of infinite. And you need gain of infinite, VD must be 0. And if VD must be 0, V1 and V2 must be same. But you can't physically short both the voltage. So what you can do? You can short it virtually short. What is the meaning of virtually short? You will make a system by which these both terminals value A and B will become approximate similar. I mean this VA becomes approximate similar to B. This is very much similar to VA VB. But you will not physically short. You can't short like this. Physically short is not allowed. But you can make this situation VA very similar to VB. So at this condition, Va minus Vb will be very low value. In that particular condition, Vd will be 0. And at that condition, A gain will be infinite. So this situation, ideal situation can occur if you will do the arrangement for this operational amplifier like this. Got it? So this is the most important concept. Now I am coming to the characteristic of the operational amplifier too. Here we can say again, that is, as I discussed, this is open loop gain, we output upon Vd. If assume that this is infinite, this tends to infinite, then Vd must be 0. If ideal amplifier, this is gain is infinite, V output infinite is not possible, because the maximum voltage is cannot be more than this saturation voltage. And saturation voltage is plus VCC or minus VE. Okay, so find the minimum input voltage to get output saturation. Minimum voltage input to get output saturation. If some student are thinking that if the gain is infinite, some student are thinking maybe that if AOL is infinite, then V output is equal to AOL multiplied by V2 minus V1. Then what is the infinite multiplied by V2 minus V1? AOL is infinite, then what is the V output value? V output is AOL multiplied by V2 minus V1. And V output is equal to infinite multiplied by V2 minus V1 is equal to, answer is infinite. If some student are thinking like this, they have a wrong concept. It is a wrong concept. Why it is a wrong concept? Because again I am telling that output cannot be infinite. Why output cannot be infinite? Because the energy conservation rule comes here, that whatever the input energy we are giving, the output energy cannot be more than the input energy. And output energy can be the maximum of the input energy. And whatever the input is maximum, maximum input is here. Whatever the VCC I have applied here, this is the bias voltage. Suppose I have here 12 volt. And suppose here I have applied minus 12 volt. Then whenever this output will be more than 12 volt, it will saturate and the output will be the constant. I mean V output will vary from plus minus, like here V output will be greater than minus 12 and less than or equal to plus 12. This is the range of V output. Got it? This important concept is also here. If you are thinking like this, that gain is infinite, then output also will be infinite. This is completely a wrong concept. This is a completely a wrong concept if you are thinking. Okay, so what is the range of output? Output cannot be greater than VCC and cannot be less than minus VE. Okay, so here I have given the name of this is saturation, because saturation value I can say it is the plus saturation if go is the plus VCC, and this minus saturation goes in the minus VE. So this is, I am showing the transfer characteristic of the output. If all the things I have dictated you in the previous concept, if it understandable, you can understand that, then you can draw the transfer characteristic. What is the mean of transfer characteristic? Your difference of the Vd. What is the Vd? Vd is the difference between two input voltage. This is this point. Both input, this voltage minus this voltage equal to Vd. Difference of the voltage. When you are changing the difference voltage, output is going to change. What is happening here? See here. Here I am increasing step by step my Vd and output is increasing. But at that particular point, what is my output? Output is plus VCC. What is the value of plus V saturation barabar? Plus VCC. And what is the minus V saturation barabar? Minus VEE. So whenever output reach at this particular point, after that I am increasing the Vd, but my output is not increasing. That is very, very important. You have to understand that why it is happening. It doesn't mean have always you will increase the input and output will go on. No, this will not happen. So this is a limit of input. And again, in the negative side, if you are applying the negative voltage, then it will increase up to this minus V saturation. And when this voltage will occur in the output, this is the axis, Y axis is output. And what is the X axis? X axis will be the difference of input voltages. Input voltage of both terminal, terminal 2 and terminal 1. Terminal positive minus of terminal negative. So we can say after this, if you are more negative, you will apply, more difference will come. Then the voltage of at output will become constant. That's the important point. So if you want to see the reason, so this reason is called as the operating reason. Why? Because this is a linear reason. And I said to you that inside a triangle, this is just a symbol. This is a triangle is just a symbol. And inside this, basically a transistor is there. Maybe the BJT, maybe JFET, maybe MOSFET, but all are transistor. And I would like to work in the transistor with its linear reason. From my previous classes, if you attended that bipolar junction transistor, I have detailed I discuss what is the reason behind. I am interested in the linear reason, and that's the same thing is going to apply here. It is not a new thing, because operational amplifier and nothing but inside the transistor is inside that triangle. So operational range, operating range, if you want to operate the transistor, operate this amplifier, I will operate this amplifier in this particular region only, because in this region output versus input, the linear graph is here. But this is called the saturation region. What is this is called? This is called the saturation region. What is this is called? This is called the saturation region. So this is the saturation region beyond this region. It is also called the linear region. It is called the active region. An active region is not new for you, because in the BJT we have discussed in the detail. The purpose of DC biasing, the whole sole purpose of the DC biasing to make and to be the transistor in active region. Same thing is happening here. Now again, this is the important line that is the conclusion of, it is the moral of the story. To get infinite gain, VD, difference of the terminal voltage, must be zero, which is known as virtual short concept. VD equal to zero. It means non-inverting voltage must be inverting voltage. So if anybody ask you what is the virtual concept or what is the virtual ground of operational amplifier, first of all, you have to draw this circuit. This whole circuit you have to draw. It doesn't mean whatever you have written here. You may write down V1, V2. You may write down Vx, Vy. You may inverting Vi and V not inverting. This is Ni. You may any voltage name you can give. But output must be like this. This is the formula. Gain is equal to output divided by difference of this. And what is the VD? What is the VD? VD is V non-inverting. What is the non-inverting? Whatever voltage you have applied at this terminal, positive terminal, that is the non-inverting. So VNI minus whatever the voltage you have applied in the negative terminal, that is this. So you have to draw this diagram. You have to written this formula. And you have to assume for ideal operational amplifier, a open loop gain must be infinite. Now you will write down this definition. To get infinite gain, VD must be zero, which is known as virtual short concept. Because in every year, they ask virtual concept or virtual ground concept of operational amplifier. Okay. I hope this is the basic fundamental of operational amplifier I have discussed. I have discussed this open loop triangle, this is symbol, as well as I have discussed the internal structure, this one the internal structure, as well as I have discussed this ideal characteristic or ideal parameter or ideal. These are four important points in the ideal amplifier. This is required, as well as I have discussed the practical operational amplifier. What is the value of these four points? Apart from that, I have also discussed the ideal operational amplifier. What is the virtual? You can short V1 and V2 virtually. Why you can short? This. I also discussed that if you are assuming that gain is infinite, then output voltage will be infinite. You are doing a mistake. It is a wrong concept. Why? Because output cannot be infinite at any condition. Because output energy cannot be more than the input energy because of energy conservation law. So what the output, the maximum output? Maximum output it is possible, the maximum DC supply that is you are giving here, that is a VCC. And negative side you are giving minus V. So this is a limit. So V output is a range is there. I mean this is plus V saturation and minus V saturation. So what is this? This is from this point to this point. This is a maximum limit of the output. More than this, you cannot get any output more than this. And when you are applying the input, this is a VD. It is basically difference of the both to both terminal. It is, I have mentioned V in. So this is in this particular point, this point to this point. It means what is the value of this point? Its value is V saturation divided by open loop gain. It is a minus V saturation divided by AOL. Because it is assuming that value of VCC and VE are equal. Here they have assumed VCC equal to mod of VCC barabar mod of VEE. If you have assumed this, it means this is 5 volt, this is minus 5 volt. That's it. This is 12 volt, this is minus 12 volt. So if it is both are same, just a minus and plus difference, then this is minus V saturation divided by AOL and this is plus V saturation. Now this, if you will go beyond this, the output voltage will be constant. If you be lesser than this particular point, this voltage, this output will be constant. So that is the basic transfer characteristic of this. And the last I gave a definition of the short circuit. So from my side, a basic introduction of the operational amplifier as well as ideal characteristic, transfer curve, practical characteristics and virtually ground concept has been done and is the most important topic in the operational amplifier, because further I will take application of the operational amplifier. So you must clear. If you have doubt, you can mail me. I will try to resolve. Also, for the theoretical point of view, I prepared this for you especially because you guys are very close to me. I would like to give each and every handwritten notes to you. So this is a complete handwritten material for you. If sometime in the examination they ask you what is the block diagram of operation amplifier, because in the competitive exam they don't believe in such type the theoretical question, but in the university exam or maybe the IES exam sometime you need to ready for this type of the question too. So I have written here properly what is the block diagram of operational amplifier. There are many blocks that covers that. First of all, input stage is there. An intermediate stage is there, then buffer and level shifting stage is there, then output stage. There are four stages by which you can create an operational amplifier. So what is the input stage and intermediate stage do? Both stage uses the differential amplifier, which is known as direct coupled high gain amplifier. It is just another form of operational amplifier. I mean the differential amplifier, you can say also it is an operational amplifier. But it's a special type of amplifier. So we will study that. So in that we connect the two transistor in the cascade manner. So cascade amplifier is there. We use the common emitter and the common base. You are very much familiar about both the terms. And second example of the direct couple high gain amplifier is Darlington pair. In the Darlington pair, both we use as a transistor in the common collector mode. Like first is a common collector, another one again is a common collector. So two transistor we use. And if I will just say about the buffering and the level shifting, then this I can say it is connected with the DC biasing. Especially I want to make my transistor, I want and to help the transistor to be in the active region. What is written there? This is active region. To use the follower circuit as used in this buffering and level shifting, because that is also important, because if the transistor will be in the active region only, then it will amplify the signal, and that exactly exists inside a operational amplifier. So if the BJT case, it is an active region, and in the MOSFET region I would like to maintain the MOSFET region in the saturation region. Here again, I want to tell, I want to show one of the things to you that why I have written there in the BJT, like in the BJT, and this is the MOSFET. In the last class, I have discussed that this is both have the same diagram of output characteristic, both have the same diagram. But this particular region is an active region in the BJT. And this particular region is called the saturation region. So just as the name is different, here is the active this is saturation. What is called? This is ohmic region. Ohmic region. So this is the saturation region, this is just a name difference. That's why I have written here. This is for the BJT is in the active region, and for MOSFET is the saturation region. Okay. So more than that, in the what is the output stage? This is the output state, detail of that. And before that is also important line. Above circuit is used to maintain the DC level of the amplifier or active. What is the difference? DC level of the operation amplifier or the active region of the in the BJT. It's the same thing. I want to make the transistor in active region. And output stage? Output stage we can use the push-pull amplifier. What is the purpose of the output stage? Purpose of the high output voltage? I want to create? Yes. I want to create high output. Otherwise, what is the need of amplifier? If the voltage is very low, what is the need of? I want high output. And high current swing capability? Yes. If the current is swinging in a large range, it has to be able to handle that. Low power dissipation? Yes. In the whole world, in every system, in every circuit, I want low power dissipation. So it is not a new term, like, you know, third point is not a big deal. You must know if you are, you know, from electronics, you are talking about short circuit protection. Yeah, that's also important. If somewhere is a short circuit, it may be a dangerous thing. So you have to protect that. So how you can protect? With the help of push-pull amplifier. And there are a lot of push-pull amplifier, class A, class B, class C, class D. So here we are using the class B. So basically this is a part of your, you know, third year syllabus, but you have to understand whole block diagram. Why? Because they can ask you the 5 marks question of the operational, you know, amplifier. So remember that whenever they are asking you the question of operational amplifier, you cannot forget to draw this basic circuit. This is a basic circuit. It's a triangle. This is a VCC. This is minus VEE. This is output. This is input, and this is the difference of the input, and this is the formula of gain. So this is the, you know, it is a Ram Ban. It's like a, you know, short mantra of the operational amplifier. Every question you are going to attempt, you have to draw this. You will get extra marks of this circuit. No, you will not get extra marks. But it give a right impression on the teacher that you a bit have a good understanding of operational amplifier. It will take just 5 seconds to draw. And I hope you have done a lot of practice, so it will take 5 seconds. Okay, so this was the first time, I think this is the second lecture of operational amplifier. Again, we will come back. I will come back surely, and I hope the same from your side too. In the next lecture, that is the base on application of operational amplifier. Okay.